بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد عليكم بشفاعين الأصل والقرآن. The narration of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud ibn Majah and Hakim that hold steadfast, resort to, turn your attention to, utilize honey and the Qur'an. The Qur'an is the remedy for the ruh, the soul, and asal is the remedy for the body. Riwayat of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, shifa fi thalatha. That shifa is in three things. One of them is shurbatu aslin, that utilizing honey. So to understand firstly the work, the magnitude, the scale that Allah has engineered behind the scenes. To appreciate it, we need to go behind the scenes and see how much work and energy and resources are utilized for us to get this bounty, yet it has no value. So from the honeybee colony, we have the queen of bees, the drone, and the worker bees. The worker bees are the masturat, the ladies, the females that are in charge of cleaning the hive, caring for the larva and the young, feeding the queen and the drones, the male bees, building and maintaining the combs, maintaining the hive ventilation, maintaining security, gathering and storing such substances like nectar, pollen, water, resin. And it is amazing, look at Allah's power, how such a small creature can take so much responsibility and fulfill that responsibility successfully. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ. Allah has given insan superiority of every creation on earth, but because our niyat, our azam, our ambition, our vision is small. أَنَا عِنْدَ ظَنِّ عَبْدِي بِهِ. How we expect of Allah, that's how Allah will treat us. Because we have not made big niyats and intentions, we don't see a lot of barakah in time and life. So, in the hive itself, there is a security system which precautions are taken to make sure that any stranger doesn't come close by. So any foreign bees entering the hive, researchers, scientists say that there is an odor that is secreted in the hive which makes bees recognize each other. So we understand also that each colony has a mahal and environment. Likewise in deen, the ulama, the mashayikh that we associate with, and the mahal that we in environment we are in will have an effect on us, and we have to guard ourselves as well from outside elements that will destroy our akhirat. If any bee does come in, then it gets attacked. Likewise, even if a hive is attacked, then the bees release a chemical substance, this pheromone secretion puts the entire hive in motion, and the bees are ready to sacrifice their lives to see the preservation of the colony. So the nature and the mizaj of insan is we are not ready to sacrifice ourselves for the benefit of mankind, whereas we should be sacrificial, not artificial. Then the bees that set out and get in the nectar, the pollen, the water, these concentrations on an average one colony needs around 50 kilos of pollen per year. Half of the pollen is used for the larva, to feed the larva, and the worker bees, which are the most senior bees in the hive, and they seek the food. They fly at a speed of 65 kilometers per hour. They can travel 46 kilometers non-stop. And when carrying the nectar, they travel at 30 kilometers per an hour with a vibration of their wings at a speed of 250 times per second. So to put 1 kg of honey, an average bee must travel 90,000 to 180,000 times. So if every trip on an average it takes 3 kilometers to go, a bee travels between 90 and 180,000 kilometers to complete this task. Then the bee needs to find the best pollen. So it goes out, it seeks and searches it. When it is found, it returns to the nest. And now it needs to notify the other bees of the location. So scientists have been baffled. They've given some scenarios to say that the bee makes a certain movement and gives a direction with regards to the sun, but also it is questionable because the sun moves, and how does the sun affect the direction where the bee is given? So there is a scientific explanation which may be flawed, but this is alone the Qudrat of Allah, how a bee gives the GPS location exactly where other bees should go. Then the cells in the nest are in the form of a hexagon, and it is a marvel, engineering marvel, where it stores honey, it traps oxygen, other elements, and if it was another shape, researchers say that the bee would not have been so successful. Wa'auha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired the bee. So like how the creation of Allah have been inspired, how to do a certain task which Allah has created them. We insan have been inspired by Allah through wahi, through Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. When we fulfill and follow this inspiration, then the result will be honey, which will be shifa'ul linnas, will be a benefit to mankind. The bees also use propolis in constructing the hive, and this is to repair the crevices, holes in the walls. So in certain volcanic areas like Italy, the temperatures are hot and cause the combs to melt. So propolis protects that. Then they care for their young. So there are different stages in the bees when they grow, from the larval stage to the pupal stage. And the queen carries on laying her eggs, and the bees take care of developing the young. So the worker bees look after them, where they prepare the incubation cells, they prepare the combs. When the queen bee lays the eggs, then she moves on from each cell. And then they feed the larva until they hatch. They make sure there is a stabilization of the temperature. And after about 3 days, the eggs that the queen placed into the cells, they start hatching like larva. When they hatch, they have no eyes, wings or legs, and they don't resemble a bee at all. These worker bees visit these larvae sometimes 10,000 times during its period of growth. So the larvae are then fed royal jelly, and they are fed constantly so that they develop. The larva's weight increases about 1,500 times in just 6 days. And there are thousands of larvae, thousands of bees. But in this outside commotion, there is organizations. It's systematic and it's organized. So this is quite amazing considering so much activities happening. So ulama explain that when we follow Allah and His Rasul, then a lot of work will be done in little time. And when we don't follow, then we'll do a lot of work and we will do a lot of effort, but there'll be no results. So it'll take us a long time to do just a little work. So that's barakah. And Imam Umar Sahib Palanpuri used to say, if you have to make effort for 1,000 years, compared to Sahaba which made effort in plus minus 26 years till the Khilafat of Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu, if you made effort in any other line of dunya, would you have not gotten so much barakah like Sahaba got barakah? So if Sahaba decided we'll do effort in farming, trade, business for 1,000 years, what treasures, what wealth of dunya, forget the wealth of deen, the wealth of akhirat, what Allah gave them in that few years, even for thousands of years, they would have not achieved it. The secret is to follow Allah and His Rasul. Then the death of the workers, constantly they are dying. Why? Because the wax glands degenerate, and flying on an average bee which flies around 800 kilometers, their muscles wear out. And because of the amount of effort, we see an average hive or colony would survive for 20 years or more. And then amazing, the queen bee, which is the Amir, the Shura, the Markas. So they follow the Mashura of the queen bee. And that also is important, that when we are instructed by ulama, by mashayikh, through Mashura, a decision is decided. Then some ulama have also extracted shirtul asl. When you take out the honey, you're extracting the honey. But that's by through Mashura, shirtu, from Mashura. That when you follow Mashura and you follow what has been decided, then there'll be barakah, there'll be khair, and the results will be positive. فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Then we must know Allah's help is with you. So after 2 or 3 days after the mating process is complete, the queen bee starts laying her eggs one by one. The cells are prepared and she continues this process non-stop. And during the laying period, she lays around 1,500 to 2,000 eggs. Where there is necessity, she can increase it to 3,000. So realistically, one fertilized egg is laid every minute. And it has been calculated that single queen may lay over 1.5 million eggs within a year. So given the normal lifespan, a single queen will lay millions of eggs. And in addition, the total weight of the eggs laid by the queen during one day is equivalent to that of her body. So in a day, she repeats the laying of eggs approximately 1,500 times in a day. As she grows elderly, the rate of her laying decreases and the laying of eggs drops. And then when they realize it, other worker bees start making effort and feeding and raising new queens. So automatically there's a motion in place as the queen bee gets elderly for a replacement. Then the male bees, after fertilizing the queen, they expel from the hive because they've completed their task. And generally the mating takes place at high altitudes above 4.5 meters. And the male bee dies after mating. Even if the ones that don't mate also, they are killed. And the worker bees change completely to the males after the mating period, and they are not allowed to enter the hive. And that's the end of the male bees. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created a system, الرِّجَالُ قَوَّامُونَ عَلَى النِّسَاءِ, with regards to men who have their responsibilities, women who have their responsibilities. When we stick and we confine ourselves to that structure which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has engineered, we will see khair and barakah and afia. So we should try to maintain what Allah has given us as a responsibility. So a lot of research has been done with regards to honey. Dr. Sackett, who is a germ specialist, Colorado Agricultural College, had carried out tests and he found that germs do not survive in honey. Likewise, Dr. Lockheed, who followed up this research in the University of Ottawa, found that germs which cause human disease generally just died off due to the purity of honey. So people say that, but it's sugar also. So researchers say that it is a better alternative, and there's a great difference between normal sugar and honey in its effects, in its benefits, and in its nutrition. And one study shows that type 2 diabetes, where honey increased the blood sugar level, unlike normal sugar, which it doesn't decrease the triglycerides, and there is a factor of LDL, bad cholesterol. Dr. Ahmed Shawqi Ibrahim from Kuwait did research, and he's saying from 1937, where the honey was proven to be an antibiotic, from 17 different types of microbes to 1958, where they found there's a special effect in the enzymes of honey. In 1960, where they found that it had glycolic acid and the specific ingredients in honey which made it unique, which researchers did test. And then they took 149 cases of tract infection of patients, where there were 100,000 microbes per cubic centimeter. And the results showed that the bacteria was sufficient to kill all or most of the microbes. Then research from 1970 onwards which showed the healing power, and it is found that it is a remedy for infected wounds, burns, and medically it was beneficial. Dr. Saleh Najm from Cairo also did research on 45 patients who had indigestion, duodenal ulcers, stomach problems, and honey was administered 3 times a day before meals. And people who had gastric bleeding, stomach pains, acidity, swelling in the upper abdomen, nausea, vomiting, ulcers, infection. And the conclusion was that there was evidence that honey had a prominent role in diseases in the digestive system. So whether it was administered through injection or orally taking it, the large intestine, small intestine, ulcers, other stomach problems, even up to diseases of poisoning of heavy metals, liver diseases, skin diseases. And his results demonstrated that honey had a healing effect even in wounds and chronic ulcers. Then Dr. Mohammed Amara from Egypt also did research, and he found that patients who had issues with the eyes, so a patient, for example, who had scotoma in the cornea, a patient who was 30 years old and he had exhausted avenues with regards to specialist doctors, after coming to him, doctor also administered normal medication and found that if he had to delay, even though he used normal medical medication, allopathic, delay in treatment would have caused the patient's cornea and permanent scotoma, which obviously would lead to permanent eye loss and eyesight. So he decided to use honey. And after using honey, he found the results were very amazing, and it sparked on where after this patient took it, it calmed the corneal infection and it healed within 6 weeks. And then other researchers started doing research in this field as well with regards to the eye. So we have heard of surma and utilizing surma as well, but we can use honey as well. The amal for today is that protecting the private parts. So Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam has said that one of those people who is enticed by a beautiful woman, and he says, Inni akhafu Allah, I fear Allah, I will not come close to you, I will not commit zina. He will be on the VIP booth in front of Allah on the day of Qiyamah. May Allah give us tawfiq of making amal wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.